Welcome to Learn Commerce PU Online Classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello my dear students, welcome back to first year accountancy online classes. Dear students, we are discussing about the basic accounting concepts, right? So we are able to say the meaning of dual aspect concept, we are able to say the meaning of business entity concept and many other important basic accounting concepts. Let's understand the revenue recognition concept. See, these all concepts, these all assumptions are the fundamental ideas or assumptions which are required or which are essential to the accountants or the business professionals to record the transaction and to report the financial statements to the interested users. Correct, right? That is what basic accounting concept, or these concepts are generated or developed through a long period of time, and it is also the part of generally accepted accounting principles that we know. So revenue recognition concept is the next concept which is needed to be studied. This concept, why? Because it states that revenue for a business transaction should be included in the accounting records only when it is realized. In the other words, in simple words, revenue should be recorded when it has been received. When it has been received means when it has been earned, not when received. See, we know that cash transaction and credit transactions are exist in business activities. Cash transaction means payment of cash at the time of sale or purchase of goods. Credit transaction means giving a time period or some time to repay or to pay the amount. That is what credit transaction. Saalakke goods ana koduvantadu athava thagoluvantadu. Credit transaction. So here revenue, we should record each and every transaction in the books of account. That is very important and essential function of accounting. So here revenue recognition says that what revenue for a business transaction should be included in the books of accounts or at the time of recording the transaction only when it is realized. That's why this revenue recognition concept is also called as realization concept. What is that? Realization concept. According to this concept, revenue is recorded. Revenue of the company should be recorded when it has been earned, not received. Say, you should consider the transaction related to revenue transaction. Say, when you create an invoice or bill for your customer for goods or services, for the usage of goods or services, that amount of the invoice or bill is recorded in the books of account as revenue at that time or at that time. And it means what? Yavaga neevu bill prepare martiro, invoice anna prepare martiro, ade time alli enanta consider maadbeku, ಆ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ನಿಮಗೆ ಬರಲಿ ಬರದೇ ಇರಲಿ, ಇನ್ನು ಮುಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಬರೋದಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಬಟ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್, ದಟ್ ಸೇಲನ್ನು ನೀವೇನಂತ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ರೆವೆನ್ಯೂ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ, ರೆವೆನ್ಯೂ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಅರ್ನ್ಡ್, ನಾಟ್ ವೆನ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್. ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ, ಬಟ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಎಟ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅರ್ನ್ ರೆವೆನ್ಯೂ ಬಟ್ ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ ರೆವೆನ್ಯೂ. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ ದ ರೆವೆನ್ಯೂ ಇನ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಡೇಸ್, ಇನ್ ಅ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಡೇ, ಅಗ್ರೀಡ್ ಡೇಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ ದಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಯಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಡೆಪ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ know the meaning of two basic terms. One is revenue and when the revenue can be realized. Revenue means the total cash inflows. Revenue means what? The total cash inflows arising from two different activities. One is the revenue arising from sale of goods or services, that is a main source of revenue to each and every organization. And the second main is what? If the asset of the if asset of your organization or the resources of your organization is utilizing by some other organization or entity, for that you are receiving some interest or some royalties or any other dividends and all, that is also considered as revenue for your organization. So that is about the revenue. Then when it has been realized, how we can find out revenue is realized or not? See, revenue is realized at the time of goods or sale of goods or services. At the time of sale of goods or services means thus credit sales also are also considered as a revenue on the day. Revenue on the day are made means on the day the sales are made. Yavaga sales anna martiro ade dinada revenue anta heli consider agutte, and not when money is received from your customer. Credit sale means time gap kottirtiri pay madlike. Say for example, today you are selling 10,000 worth goods on credit base, and you can and the agreed date is to repay that amount after 15 days. But you should consider that transaction as a revenue of this particular day. Of this particular day, 15 days between you record madadalla. Ivatte record madbeku. Footnote anna mention madidre aitu, it's credit sales annodu. That is what? You should record the transaction when the transaction was took up in the organization. At that time only you should record the transaction. Say, for the income such as rent, interest or commission, these are realized on time basis, fixed period of time only these incomes are or revenues are realized. Say for example, you can say that interest or the rent of the March 2017 may be received in the month of April 2017. March 2017 alli barbekadantha rent 2017 April alli generate agide, receive agide, but you should consider this amount, you should consider or this will be taken into record in the profit and loss account in the year relates to the March 31st March 2017 and not into the financial year of next year beginning, means with the April 2017. ee April 2017 alli receive madirbodu, but income yavagaddu March 2017 idu. So profit and loss account alli rent anna record madbekadre you should record the transaction in the previous year, means March 2000 year. At the end of the year profit and loss account alli record madbeku, not the beginning of this year. Same way, if the income or any interest or rent is received in advance, say for example April 2018 interest or commission is received in the year March 2018, but that amount is considered as the recorded in the next financial year. Up to that it is, that amount is considered as liability for the organization. See, at March will be taken into profit and loss account of the financial year ending March 2017, like that. Getting my point? This is about revenue recognition concept. Move to matching concept. Here, expenses incurred in an accounting period should be matched with the revenues during that period. See, here expenses is recognized not when cash is paid. not when cash is paid, but when an asset or services has been used to generate revenue. According to the revenue recognition concept, revenue is recognized when sale is complete. When sale is complete or services provided by the service render is when, not when cash received. ಯಾವಾಗ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅವಾಗ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡೋದಲ್ಲ. ಯಾವಾಗ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತೇವೋ, ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೋ, ಆ ದಿನದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ರೆವೆನ್ಯೂ ಅಂತ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ. ಹಾಗೇನೆ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಮ್ಯಾಚಿಂಗ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ರೆಕಗ್ನೈಸ್ಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಪೇಯ್ಡ್. ಯಾವಾಗ ನಾವು ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೇವೆ ಆ ದಿನದಲ್ಲಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ. But when an asset or services has been used to generate revenue, we need to spend some amount. At that time itself, we should consider that is that particular cost is considered as expense. Say for example, expenses such as salaries, rent or any other commissions insurance are recognized in the month, recognized on the basis of period. These all costs are recognized on the basis of period which they relate. Say for example, 2000 financial year starts from 31st April and ends on 31st March. In between we have to pay rent, we have to pay some other commissions, interest and number of clients and all. Owners agirbodu, clients agirbodu, okay. But that when these expenses are considered, means which are related and not when cash paid, whether you paid the amount or not, but those expenses are recognized and that expenses you should record in the books of account. Getting my point? You should record in the books of account. Similarly, this matching concept thus explains that what revenues earned during the period or not, during the period, whether it is received or not, or cost incurred, whether paid during the year or not. But you should consider that transactions as expense or revenue and you should record in the books of account immediately, and it relates to that particular period itself. That is about matching concept. So these are here. It says that mainly your expenses and revenue should be matched, and that expenses and revenues should be belongs to the same accounting period. Your expenses should not cross your revenues, but it says that mainly it focus on matching the expenses and matching the revenues of the same accounting period. That is relates to matching concept. Let's take down the assignment question. Write a note on revenue recognition concept. Thank you for watching this video.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.